hymns and
in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with you.
So, brothers and sisters, let us prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries by calling to mind our sins and asking the Lord's pardon. I confess to Almighty God,
and to you,
my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And let us pray. O God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and of our neighbor, grant that by keeping your precepts, we may merit to attain eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Ezra. At the time of the evening sacrifice, I, Ezra, rose in my wretchedness, and with cloak and mantle torn, I fell on my knees, stretching out my hands to the Lord my God. I said, "My God, I am too ashamed and confounded to raise my face to you. O my God, for our wicked deeds are heaped up above our heads, and our guilt reaches up to heaven. From the time of our fathers, even to this day, great has been our guilt, and for our wicked deeds we have been delivered up, we and our kings and our priests, to the will of the kings of foreign lands, to the sword, to captivity, to pillage, and to disgrace, as is the case today. And now, but a short time ago, mercy came to us from the Lord our God, who left us remnant and gave us a stake in his holy place. Thus our God has brightened our eyes and given us relief in our servitude. For slaves we are, but in our servitude, our God has not abandoned us. Rather, he has turned the goodwill of the kings of Persia toward us. Thus, he has given us new life to raise again the house of our God and restore its ruins, and has granted us a fence in Judah and Jerusalem." The word of the Lord. Blessed be God who lives forever. He is gracious and then has mercy. He casts down to the depths of the nether world, and he brings up from the great abyss. No one can escape his hand. Praise him, you children of Israel, before the Gentiles, for though he has scattered you among them, he has shown you his greatness even there. So now consider what he has done for you, and praise him with full voice. Bless the Lord of righteousness, and exalt the King of ages. In the land of my exile, I praise him and show his power and majesty to a sinful nation. Bless the Lord, all you his chosen ones, and may all of you praise his majesty. Celebrate days of gladness and give him praise.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus summoned the 12 and gave them power and authority over all demons and to cure diseases. He sent them to proclaim the kingdom of God and to heal the sick. He said to them, "Take nothing for the journey, neither walking stick, nor sack, nor food, nor money, and let no one take a second tunic. Whatever house you enter, stay there and leave from there. And as for those who do not welcome you, when you leave that town, shake the dust from your feet in testimony against them." Then they set out and went from village to village, proclaiming the good news and curing diseases everywhere. The Gospel of the Lord. I'd like to look at that first reading there, which is from the Old Testament book of Ezra. The Jewish people, first of all, remember that the Catholic religion came from the Jewish religion, and there are a lot of things in our Catholic practices that reflect back on the Jewish religion and their practices. And this fellow that wrote this book, Ezra, is looked at by the Jews as a very important man. In fact, probably even second to Moses, and they think very highly of Moses because Moses is the one that they believe wrote the Torah, the first five books of the Bible. So at this particular time now, we're talking about sometime in the 400s or late, 400s or early 500s before Christ years. The people of remember, if you've heard of the Babylonian exile, around the year 600 BC, the Jewish people were exiled, driven from their city. In fact, a foreign king came in, Nebuchadnezzar, and destroyed the city and took some of the nobles and others captives and over in Babylon, which today is Iraq. And so they lived there for probably 40 to 50 years, maybe even longer. So it was an exile, it was a punishment, because the people of Israel had not been living according to the commandments, according to the law of God. And so finally God had enough. And because they were not living according to the law of God, they were weak before their enemies. And not only physical enemies, but spiritual enemies. So they'd been exiled now to Babylon, and now we're around the year, or as I said, around 400 years to 500 years before Christ. So about 100 years after the exile, this man has been permitted by one of the Persian kings to come back to the city of Jerusalem. And the reason why the people were in exile in Babylon is because of their sinfulness, and they began to recognize that. This is the punishment from God. And so God is not only one who punishes, because God is just, but God is merciful. And God permitted the people to come back to Jerusalem, and now this man is recognizing, repenting, in effect, of his sins and of the sins of the nation. Which is a good thing, to repent and reflect on our lives and ask God's forgiveness. Because God is merciful, but he wants us to recognize, first of all, that we've strayed. And so this is what he's doing, and asking God's pardon and recognizing that they've done evil. And so there's a need for change there. So you might, how do we bring this to today's practices? Well, how long ago was Katrina came through here, Hurricane Katrina? Is it 10 years ago? And then we've just had Hurricane Ida. And we've had a few other hurricanes in the meantime, flooding, houses destroyed right now. There's just something in the Advocate paper here just yesterday about a couple of their house was destroyed. They went to live with their daughter, and then their car was flooded. So what's going on here? Fires in the West, more damage by Ida up in New Jersey, I think, in New York than it was here. Is God sending us a message, you think, that there needs to be reflection in this country and in our lives personally about what we can do better to live the way God wants us to live as God's images? And now, because we're baptized, we're talking about God's sons and daughters. What needs to change? I personally think these are messages. I personally think we're getting close to the second coming of Jesus, but that's my personal opinion. But I do see these things that are going on in our country and throughout the world, all the wars that are going on. War is caused by sin. So what needs to change? And I think really radical change in our lives and in our country. Abortion is one of the great evils of our time. That needs to stop. So we've got lots of work here, and we can do as Ezra did and begin to reflect on where in our individual lives we need to make changes and where we need to make changes in our state and in our country to draw closer to the way God wants us to live. And I think things would radically calm down here if we made some radical changes in our lives. But again, that's in our hands. And I'm sorry, this is kind of the first time here. Do we do intentions right now?
Yes, Father.
Okay. So, relying on God's mercy in our lives, let us bring our prayers before him. For the church in its work to continue the mission of the 12, may God strengthen her as she proclaims the gospel throughout the world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who work to uphold justice, may the Holy Spirit imbue them with the gifts of understanding and knowledge. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who struggle to forgive themselves, may God's abundant presence be with them. Let us pray to the Lord. For this faith community, may God strengthen our commitment to spreading the gospel message. Let us pray to the Lord. And for those who have died, may God's infinite love welcome them into eternal life. Let us pray to the Lord. And today we're praying especially for the soul of Dana Parmalee. So for the repose of the soul of this person, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the healing and recovery of Father Jeff Bailly, Nita Poole, Father Joe Doyle, and Phil Slaughter, and other members of our families and community that are sick and injured, we pray to the Lord. And now our special intentions. We pray to the Lord. Almighty and ever-living God, listen to the prayers we place before you this day. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these heavenly mysteries, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts, and let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in goodness you created man, and when he was justly condemned, in mercy you redeemed him, through Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore, and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, for they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, O Lord, we pray graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect, Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in the faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants, the poor souls in purgatory who have gone before us with a sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And
we offer each other a sign of peace. Thank you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
And let us pray. Graciously raise up, O Lord, those you renew with this sacrament, that we may come to possess your redemption, both in mystery and in the manner of our life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Souls,
Lord,
Jesus Christ, Son of Father,
send your mercy.
O Immaculate Heart of Mary,
pray for us.
O Sacred Heart of Jesus,
have mercy on us.
That's it.
Jesus, we